has been teaching for environmental studies at Tsukuba in Japan. So I'm going to share my personal experience with Marie Skłodowska's reaction indigenous fellowship. Just first briefly about my background, I was born and raised in Japan, but I left Japan after my my bachelor degree here, and I was abroad for 16 years until I actually landed a job at my current institute in September 2014, and I spent actually 12 years in Europe, and mainly actually Central Europe. I just marked the map, but mostly German-speaking countries, but except for actually 1.5 year stay in Oslo, Norway. And I had actually 4 jobs before my current job, and they are actually all short, but the 2 are really long. The first one, that's about 3 years, that was another fellowship, and the second large one is actually here, and that was a very good fellowship. And the other 2 kind of fill in the gap between the jobs. And yeah, I have to mention that my background actually, I'm a climate scientist, I work on climate change issues. So here's kind of overview of my Marie Curie Fellowship. And that was the inter-European individual fellowship. That term actually doesn't exist anymore, but that actually corresponds to European fellowship in the current Horizon 2020. And it was from May 2011 to April 2013. And the host issue was in Zurich in Switzerland. And the project title was Quantifying Uncertainty in Climate Projections, including biogeochemical feedbacks and climate change. And the idea was that there are already many future projections of global climate change, but there was one missing kind of process or mechanism that hasn't been accounted for. So the idea was to sort of implement this relationship in the projection of future climate change and to see how it's going to change. And actually I'd love to talk about this fellowship, but you just mentioned 2 pros and 2 cons. And first, it was a really great opportunity for scientific exchange. I learned actually quite a lot. And the good thing for this fellowship was that there actually a lot of freedom of doing science. So I also spent a time for something that was not part of the project. And in my case, this fellowship worked as an opportunity to set up additional collaboration, which actually still even continues today. And I had one paper last year, so it actually became a kind of long-term collaboration in the end. And I have 2 cons. And first, this 2 year period is actually really short, and that's obvious, but this period includes kind of initial phase to sort of setting up the life and to get used to the new work environment. And also this also includes the time to find the next job. So in the end, actually this 2 year means less than that, and then that actually really busy and really condensed. And the last point, actually this is actually not necessarily a con, but this emphasizes the negative aspect, but the this fellowship allows you to leave everything on your own. So it's good that you have a lot of freedom. On the other hand, you have to be really attentive to everything you are doing. So it's all on you. So sometimes it's kind of hard to keep track on what I actually wanted to do. So well, that's a bit of risk with fellowship. But on the other hand, if you are funded by kind of larger project, you have colleagues who have the kind of same type of responsibility, so that actually naturally allow you to work with others, but fellowship is a bit different because it's all on yourself. So there are just some points that I want to mention, that's my last slide. So how to draft a successful proposal? And first of all, it's very important to identify an interesting scientific idea to pursue. If I look at the guideline, on how to actually evaluate the proposal, I think this element actually gets only 20% or 30% of the total score, but I think that's really core to really the right one to write a proposal. So I think one shouldn't really underestimate the importance of idea in a proposal. And the second point is to follow the application guideline precisely. After I came back to Japan, I applied for some kakengi, but the compared to my experience with kakengi, the Marie Curie actually have a very specific guidelines on what to write and how they are evaluated. So I think it's really very important to follow, actually be careful and also follow what one is supposed to write. And I wanted to mention that when I write up my application, I attended a workshop on how to write a Marie Curie proposal in Switzerland, and that was a very, very useful thing that I did to really improve my application, because there was people who gave me really specific feedback on my application draft. So if there's something similar in Japan as well, I'd really encourage you to try to get such an opportunity. And the other things are actually financial issue. So in my case, I did my fellowship in Switzerland where the cost of living is very high. So the amount of fellowship was not sufficient to cover my full-time employment at my host institute. So I did some compromise, and also the university also did some effort to hire me for 2 years. So I think if you're aiming for a country with high living costs, I think it's worth checking, you know, what would happen if the amount of funding is not sufficient to cover your stay for 2 years. And the language issue, it's actually not often specified. I mean, in my view, I highly recommend that fellow put efforts to learn the local language for a better social integration. I mean, usually science is fine with English, but the fellowship is not just science, but also the experience of mobility. So it's very important to understand local language to understand or to also appreciate what's happening around you. So I would really highly recommend some efforts to the local language if you don't know it. And the last point is that a prestigious fellowship is not a goal, but a means to achieve even more. When I had this fellowship, I had a lot of actually good words on me because of this prestigiousness of this fellowship. But this fellowship runs only for 2 years, and what is more important is, you know, how to make use of this opportunity and what you're actually going to do after and also beyond this fellowship. So it's something I think is good to keep in mind. So that's all I want to say. So thank you for listening.
For a nice chance to talk about my experience of my Marie Curie in Gibeah fellowship. And my name is Tashiro, and I was working as a postdoc in the Etihad League, Switzerland, so same to Tanaka-san, but in a bit different period. And the science field is also quite different, so maybe it's, yeah. So today I talk about 4 points. The first one is how I obtained the IIF, and second point, how I interact with the post through IIF. And the third point is my personal feeling about IIF. I say IIF because, but it's IF actually. And the last point is how IF influenced my career. And the first one, how I obtained the IIF. So before moving to Switzerland, I was doing a postdoc in Japanese Institute, which is National Institute of Agrobiological Sciences near in Japan. And my study is on the to dissect the molecular mechanisms of gene silencing, gene regulation by similar DNAs. And my technical approach is based on the in vitro biochemistry. And after working as a postdoc, I need to move because of the regulation of my contract issue. And I was looking for a new position abroad, and I started contact with Olivier Wane. He was a professor in Etihad League. I contacted with him because he is already a big guy in this field, and he is using both plant animals, but different from me. He has a lot of techniques based on genetics. And we did an interview when he arrived in Japan by conference, by chance. And I successfully started to work in his lab. But this was like a half year before thinking about research. Of course, we discussed already about how to apply the idea, but our idea is to do some experiments, get results, or to show how the preliminary results for the grant application. So after this, we have a deadline around summer, and I stopped doing some bench work, and I just focused on writing, let's say, entire 2 months, focusing on writing. And writing is not only about your project itself, but also you need to think about not only what is the advantage of me, but also what's the advantage of the host to take me. So in my case, I'm doing like a biochemistry, and which could well complement the genetics. So it's a good combination of thought. And it worked. And from our lab, we have 3 applicants from different countries with different concepts, and we all succeeded. So it was very nice. And so I worked as a senior postdoc and a molecular fellow in IA. So second point, how I interacted with my host through IA. So the left one is me, and postdoc, and IA fellow, and my boss, the supervisor is the boss of the lab, and the professor in ETHA, and the OBBA. And as a postdoc, of course, I do experiments, get results every day. This is like a as usual, and the post institute provided me a lot of good things to support my science. I cannot list up everything, but if I put list up 3, so maybe one is gardener for plants, and constantly providing my experimental materials. And the second one is we have a good facilities. For example, we have a mass spec facility to identify protein interactions. And the maybe third point is we could find good collaborators who can analyze structurally the RNA molecules, which I cannot do by myself. And this result we discuss with colleagues in the lab every day. And so we have quite many postdocs in those days. And the direct one-to-one talk to Olivier is maybe every 2 months. And I had a chance to talk about my progress in the meeting formats. And joining to the conference, blah blah. And in the beginning, so Olivier has a lot of idea to install these things to me, but in the end, through this IA fellowship, we are interactions more like a mutual. And the grant support finished, completed 2015, but until then, I couldn't publish any paper related to this grant proposal. But a bit late, but one paper has come out this year and another one is coming out. So I won't say the project is successful. And third point, my personal feeling about IIF. I really want to emphasize the preparation was tough. And without help of my OEA, I couldn't make it. Because they ask us, for example, what is his the supervisor's excellence, these things, it's not easy for me to prepare everything by myself. And he has experiences on molecular fellowship applications. So it is important to choose such people as a candidate supervisor. And maybe same to Tanaka-san says, the period is short. As a biologist, 2 years are not enough to complete something big, and I needed extra 2 years support from Olivier's budget, and like this. But basically satisfied. I was working in Swiss, but the 100% salary was supported, and I actually had certain money for my research, and in the lab and after the lab, and we have I could have made creative interactions with many lab members, which is so international, and ETH provides me a lot of opportunities to, for example, extra sciences such as language learnings. And the last point, how I have influenced my career. So as a fellow, I was a postdoc and contract with everyone here. And my current position is assistant professor, although it's not a PR in Japan. And I have a 5 years contract, so it's much stable. But however, maybe if you look at salary, it is getting lower, but this is like a country's issue, so there's no complaining. And I could have stayed in the same like a research field, although I'm using different materials, for one instance. And in future, I want to find like a PR position in academia without worry for the contract and salary. So what I want to say, my point is like a IF is a really, really basis of my like a hopefully successful career stuff. Thank you very much.
Now we will have
a
last, but not least.
My name is Masuda from the University of Tokyo. This is my great pleasure to be here. So thank you, Matthew, for arranging this. So today I will talk about my experience of the Marie Curie International Incoming Fellowship hosted by Kew University in the UK. So the period is from 2008 to 2010. For 18 months. The project is about the first stars in the universe. I'm an astrophysicist, so working on the first stars in the universe. So, but in the morning session, the acronym is important, so, but in this case, it's very terrible. I found it just taking the first characters of the sentence. So, anyway. So the host researcher was Dr. Raphael Hirsch, as shown in the photograph. But in my case, it is unusual, but it happened to any researchers. The host researchers changed because the previous host researcher, Dr. Paul Kaumig, he was a lecturer at Kiev University, went to Canada before I went to Kiev. So Dr. Raphael Hirsch took over the lecturer position. So that is a bit unusual. Okay, the talk consists of four questions as Ikki-san, as the same as Ikki-san, because these four questions are provided by organizer. So how do I work with the post-researchers? And what did I do in Europe? And the final question is the same. How did the IIF influence my career? The first question, how did I attend this round? The answer is simple, just by spending sufficient time to prepare documents. With the help of host researchers in Kiev, I had two host researchers at the time, and also a good staff at Kiev University who were an expert for grant application process. So let me make another set of questions. So how did I know about grant? Actually, a European researcher, Dr. Paul Kaumig, told me about the fellowship. So it was when I was attending the workshop in Germany in 2005. So at that time, I knew nothing about the fellowship. And I never imagined I applied for the foreign research grant. So it was a good opportunity. So the next question may be, so why did he tell me about the grant? So this is just my guess, but I guess I made a good presentation at the workshop so to attract him. So then he encouraged me to join his group at Kiev University. And actually, I had a chance to apply for the postdoc position at Kiev University, but at that time, I failed in the interview. Still, but he's kindly provided me information about how to apply the Marie Curie Fellowship. So really, I was very lucky. So instead, you are already here, and you know the existence of the fellowship, and you know what to do next. So you are much better than me, so you have made a very good start already. So how difficult was the grant application process? So I have to say, it was very difficult. Actually, the post researchers helped me a lot. So I would never have been successful without their help. So the second question is, how did you interact with the host researchers? So this is also simple, by regular meetings and conversations with the host researcher, other staff, and graduate students. But maybe you may think of a question. So what happened with the change of host researchers? In my case, fortunately, we share the same research interest with Dr. Hughes. He was also working on the first study in the universe, but in different approach. So we had no problem in continuing the proposed research project. So how did you interact with the former host researcher who went to Canada? So we had some Skype meetings, but I concentrated more on the collaboration with the key people. So then what did I do in Europe? This is my experience, and what this is just a fact. I gave 6 research presentations at conferences, 6 seminar talks during the contract. And I and host researcher published 11 papers during and after the project. This is a list of conferences I attended during the period, the contract. So the bottom 3 is actually in Japan, but I was encouraged to join these meetings, and I needed some equipment to be back to Japan to secure the next position. And here is a list of seminars in 3 places in the UK, plus your other European countries. It was a very good opportunity, and the mobility is the most important thing in living in the UK. So that is a very wonderful experience for me. The papers, I submitted the 3 papers for the reading author submitted to referee journals, and one of which was a co-author with Dr. Hughes, so it was a wonderful experience for me. So how did the IIF influence my career? So I think it has enhanced the opportunities for international collaborations and distinguished work, which has enabled me to obtain good research positions. So now I am at the town assistant professor at the University of Tokyo. So I still need to find the next position. But so far, so good, but I'm not sure for the future. So let's ask, what is an example of international collaboration that are possibly related to the IIF? So I think the collaborative studies using the database that I have developed was installed in Kyiv as well as in Japan. So that is a good start of the collaboration with the Kyiv people, and also it is helpful to promote the database that I have developed at that time. So what are examples of distinguished work that is possibly related to the IIF? So I had a chance to be a reviewer of a European research grant, and to be an external examiner for a master's degree in university in Malaysia. This never happened unless I was awarded the fellowship, I think. And also, the number of requests to be free of journal papers has dramatically increased after the contract with IIF. So I think this is feel very happy about this. So finally, let me make one more question. So what is the most critical task to be successful in the MCSA IIF grant? So my answer is to find the right collaborators and partners with the complementary expertise. So this will help, in my case, tailor the project to the grant scheme. So in my case, we changed the host researcher, but the continuation of the research project was successful, probably because we had a bigger picture to construct the research plan and research strategy. So the same thing is applied to find the strategic aims of the grant. And also, for most Japanese, we barely need help in writing the grant proposal in English. So it is also critical to find assistance from European researchers. So that's all for my presentation. Thank you very much for your attention.